Hello, dear students. How are you all? Hope everyone is doing good and being safe. Today we are going to start about your third module, learning, which you've already discussed a bit. But today I'm going to again repeat the introduction part, and I'm going to teach you in the coming classes about the learning theories and all. So let us discuss what is this learning and what are the characteristics and all. So what we are going to discuss in this video. So learning, in that meaning of learning, definition of learning, characteristics and principle of learning. So these are the factors we are going to discuss today in our class. Okay, so let us begin with the meaning and definition of learning. Okay, so I have given here, learning is an understood as the modification of behavior through practice, training and experience. Okay, so learning means, before starting anything, I just want to remind you all about one small incident which would have taken place in everybody's life. Okay, remember students, in rainy season or late May, month of May, it starts raining, right? So whenever the rain starts, you will feel that, you know, excitement, and you feel the smell of wet soil. It's a beautiful feeling, right? So whenever you feel that smell of wet soil and raining, it's pouring, you think that your mother is going to come with a cup of chai and samosa or pakode, right? Why it has happened? It has happened, like today also you feel like that in rainy season. If it is raining, or it's the summer is going to end in the month of May, or in the month of June, starting June, if it is raining, so mama will prepare us a cup of chai and she will bring us with a plate of pakodas. Right? This, how, why it has happened, why you feel like that? You feel like this feeling has came because you have learned it, right? Whenever from your childhood you are observing that your mother is, or whoever is cooking in your home, so they're going to make some special pakodas and chai whenever it rains. Okay, so that is the experience you have, you know, gained from your family. Okay, so learning is understood as modification of behavior to practice, training and experience. So students, learning is not a you know, thing which is, you know, happens just like that. So learning happens with the practice and with the training, okay, and with the experience, these three words. So what it is, we will discuss it in detail. Okay, I have given here some 5 points which will supplement the meaning of the learning, which makes us to understand the what is learning in a better way. Okay, so learning means, learning involves change. Okay, learning involves change. It is not like we are just we have experienced something and just we forgot that it has happened to us, right? So learning, what it makes, it makes us to change the behavior. Okay, so change the behavior. Say for example, you want to play cricket, but you are not a good player. Okay, so what you do, you go for the coaching, right? After going to coaching, you learn the cricket for some days. Okay, then you see the change in your play. Whenever you play cricket, before joining to any coaching institute and after joining to any coaching institute, if you compare these two, the level of, you know, activity you are doing with the cricket, so you will find the changes, right? Whenever you learn something, that will result in changes. Okay, then only it is called as learning. Okay, if it does not change, any behavior is not changing or anything is not changing, then it is not called as learning, right? So not all changes reflect learning. Okay, so you went to coaching, you took the coaching for 15 days and you have changed, but your game is, you know, reversed, went backward. That cannot be a called as, you know, learning. Okay, yes, it is, learning has a positive and negative effect, but every change which is happening, okay, because you're going to learn a cricket coaching, but there you are learning something else from any other friends or anything which is taking place in that particular place. If you're, you know, saying that I have learned it from this is the learning of a cricket practice, then it is not called as learning. Okay, you're going to learn the cricket, but if any changes related to that particular thing is called as learning. Okay, next one, learning reflects in behavior. Okay, so whatever you are learning, I said that it is a changed behavior will give you that whether your learning is changed or not. Okay, so once you learn something, your behavior will definitely change, with conscious or without conscious. You might not notice it that my behavior is changed, but it is definitely, it will reflect in your behavior. Okay, like you might not feel that I am not playing a good cricket after 15 days of coaching also, or 3 months of coaching also, or 6 months or 1 year coaching also. You might feel that I have not changed or my game is not become better, but that will be when the people are seeing your game, they will feel that, oh, this is a result of his learning, his coaching from the Cricket Coaching Institute. But you may feel that your behavior is changed, but that will definitely, your learning will definitely reflect in the your behavior. Okay, so your behavior changes when you learn. Next, the change in behavior should occur as a result of experience, practice or training. Correct. This is what I was talking about, that where the behavior is changing, but this behavior should, the change in the behavior should occur as a practice. Like you're practicing cricket for 1 year, you're practicing cricket for 6 months, then only it is called as learning. Okay, it is not like today you went to coaching, in the evening you started performing well. No, this is not learning. Okay, so learning will take place by the experience or a practice, okay, or by taking training, right? So it is not like your behavior is changed in a day, right? So that is not called as learning. The practice or experience must be reinforced in order to learning occur. Okay, to make you a better cricketer or to make you a good cricketer, what you have to do, you have to reinforce, means you have to strengthen or make your training, by training or by coaching, you have to strengthen that practice. Okay, so when you practice the game, then only you will become a perfect in that game, or you perform better in that game. So it is not like I am not practicing, I have learned it, I'm not practicing it. So take example of your own this thing, syllabus. So like papers like statistics, accounts and all, the teacher will teach you, but you are not going to practice at home, or you are not going to have some interest in learning about that subject. So how much ever the teacher taught you, that won't be remained in your mind unless you practice that subject, you practice the problems, okay, by your own. Then only you will get the expertise in that subject, and you can solve the problem, or you can answer in the examination. So this is by practice or experience we are going to learn. Okay, so I'm going to again tell now the meaning of learning. So learning is understood as modification of behavior through practice, training and experience. Okay, so this is what these 5 points will complement this meaning. So first, learning involves change. What kind of change? Okay, that change should be reflected in your behavior. Okay, learning involves change. The change should reflect in your behavior. Okay, not all changes are learning. Okay, so the change should reflect in your behavior. Every change is not a learning. Okay, the behavior should occur as a result of your experience or your practice. Okay, so experience or by practice, your behavior will change. Okay, then how the experience and practice will happen, you have to every day you have to strengthen your practice, you have to every time you have to reinforce that practice. Okay, so that is how what is learning is about. Let us discuss the definition of learning now. So learning is any permanent change, okay, in behavior of a person that occurs as a result of experience. It is accompanied by acquisition of knowledge, skills and expertise which are relatively permanent. Okay, so take the same example. This is a like cricket coaching. I'm saying a permanent change here, okay. So learning is a permanent change. Once you take a coaching of 6 months or a 1 year cricket coaching, will you perform the same thing with like an amateur? Will you perform that? You know how to hold the bat or you know how to hold the ball? No, right? Whenever you hold after coaching, after a practice or after reinforcing that training every time, so every day it has become a part of your life. Now you are practicing it every day. You're taking coaching. So you think about the day one, how you're holding your bat and how you're positioning your, yourself in the space. So that will be differentiated from how you behave after taking, learning the, by taking coaching, you have learned cricket. So after that, it changes permanently. Okay. You will not behave like how you are behaving before 1 year. Okay. So the learning is not a temporary change. The learning is a permanent change. Okay. Change in what? Change in the behavior. Okay. Change in the behavior of a person. Well, why the change in behavior will occur? Because of experience. Okay. Because you're practicing it every day for almost 6 months to 1 year. That's why it has, given you a permanent change in your behavior. That is why you have become a good player now. Okay. It is accompanied by, and experience is also accompanied by acquisition of knowledge. You learned about cricket more and skills and expertise. This would be given from your cricket coach, right? So his expertise, he's sharing. Okay, he has become coach because he knows cricket better than you. That's why he has become a coach. So he is sharing his expertise with you and he is giving skills training that, when we see cricket, we may feel that it is very easy. Somebody is throwing ball and I have to hit the ball. It is not like that. It is not a gully cricket now for you after taking 1 year of coaching. Okay. So you have to learn the every skills which is required to perform that sport, right? So the better knowledge of that sport. Okay. So now you have taken the knowledge, skill and expertise by that coaching. Okay, and you are everyday practicing it. Okay, everyday practicing it. That's why your behavior is changed permanently. That is why you have become a good player of 1 year of your cricket coaching. Okay, so learning is a permanent change. It is not a temporary change. Learning is a permanent change in behavior of a person which occurs through experience. Okay. So experience is, gained by means of, knowledge, skills, and experience. Okay. So this is what definition of the learning says about. Let us see the next slide, which says the characteristics of learning. So till now we have seen what is the meaning of learning and the definition of learning. Now we are going to discuss about the characteristics of learning. Okay. Learning is a fundamental process of life. Definitely, right? We might have heard your mother is a first teacher, your house is a first school for you. Right? This kind of, proverbs you might have heard. So learning is a fundamental. Every day we keep on learning things. Correct? It is a fundamental process. If we don't learn, you learn to walk. You learn to eat, you learn to sleep. Everything is a learning in our whatever we do in our routine day-to-day life, we think that, you know, we don't give an attention that why we are doing in a certain way, because we have learned, you know, to do it in a particular way, because we are practicing that every day, we are practicing our entire life to do that particular thing in a way. I have to sleep in night, I have to eat breakfast before 8. Some family will be having some strict rules like before 8 or before 9 you have to finish your, you know, breakfast, you have to attend your school, you have to attend your college and coaching, some sports, some entertainment activity, then you have to study, then you have to sleep. So it is a process which you are practicing from many days, right? From many days you are practicing. So learning is a fundamental process. Everything you do, whatever the behavior you perform, whatever the behavior you showcase, is a result of your learning. Okay? It's the result of your learning. Right. Next one is, it is a continuous process. It affects all modes of behavior. Right. Learning is not like one day or in 1 hour I can learn it. Learning is a continuous process. Like, we have to practice it. Right. You have to experience it every day. Then only you have a continuous process. Remember, you first time, I don't think so, you remember that first time you learn how to brush your teeth. No, you don't remember, right? So first your mother or your father or your elders, they teach you how to brush your teeth, right? So that will be not learned in one day or in one day. If you are brushing, or they have taught you brushing, no, they will teach you until you become a perfect and you can keep yourself hygiene yourself in your childhood, right? So that is how it is a continuous process. Learning, it will not stop. Learning will not stop, right? So from how to live your life, how to lead your life, from there it will go to, you know, how you have, you join schools, you learn some other kind of skills outside school. Maybe it is a sport or singing or dancing or some kind of, you know, karate classes, some kind of thing you will be learning in your life, in your entire life. Then you go to, you know, college, you attend, then you learn in the college, like whichever the course you like, you learn about it. Then you join your profession. In profession also, from experienced people, you keep on learning. Learning is a lifelong process. Learning will be, is a continuous process which will not stop. Right, so in all modes of your life, the learning will be taking place. It will not stop anyway. Next one is, learning is change in response or a behavior. Definitely, I was telling you, once you taught with something, once you are experiencing it every day, once you are practicing it every time, so you'll not do the thing, that particular thing, the similar way you choose to do in the beginning. Right, so it will change your behavior. Okay, so it is a change in behavior, which is also in the definition, right? So that change, of course, it is a change. That change may be a favorable change or unfavorable change. Okay, that change may be a favorable change or unfavorable change. Favorable change means it is a positive, like you're behaving well. Unfavorable changes, you're behaving in an opposite, like what you have to learn, you are not behaving in that way. You might be a good cricketer, or you might not be a good cricketer. It is not like you have to, you know, you have to be in a national team only. So it might, you know, it is a favorable or unfavorable results. Many times it results in unfavorable behavior also. It is not like always a good result we'll get it from the learning. Okay. Habits are the example of unfavorable behavior, right? You change, you learn, get addicted to some bad things. So it is an unfavorable change in your behavior. Okay, it is not accepted from the society like that. Okay, now next point, learning takes place when our organisms reacts to situation. Here, organisms are like any living thing which reacts to any situation. Then only the learning, like a teacher and student. When a teacher takes classes in the classroom and the students listen to her class or his class, so that is a reaction which is taking place in the classroom. That is an exchange of knowledge like that. Okay. Next one is learning is universal. Learning is not only applicable to students. Learning is not applicable to restricted to family. Learning is not restricted to only people. Learning is universal. Even your dog, if you teach to catch the ball for a few days, it will learn, right? Every insect, everything will learn, right? Learning is an universal. It is not applicable to any race, religion, culture, gender, or any city or any country. It is an universal thing which takes place. Even it is not restricted to our planet, right? There are many planets, the solar system. It is an universal thing. Learning takes place everywhere. It is not restricted to one person or one individual or one country or one family, okay? Or one college in that case. Okay, these are the characteristics of learning. That is, learning is a fundamental process. Learning is a continuous process. Learning will change in the behavior favorably or unfavorably. Learning takes place when organisms react to situation, and learning is a universal thing. So this is about the characteristics of learning. Okay, next characteristics. Learning is a total reaction of individual to the situation. Okay, so when we say a person, if a situation arises, okay, if a situation arises, how you react to the situation, okay, it is not a partial reaction we are taking a complete reaction here, right? Say for example, you have not done some assignment which is given by your faculty, okay? So what the faculty will do? The faculty will do a negative reinforcement. We say punishment. Okay. So how do you react to that punishment? Incomplete. Okay. That I am not talking about. Say for example, take me. If I am, you know, have given some assignment, some exercise to do at home, and you are turned up next day without doing it. So I may give you some punishment, like I may send you outside the class, or I may ask you to write it 5 times or something. So you might say that I won't do, I will not go out of the class because I forgot the thing, I'll bring it tomorrow. So you might react instantly for that situation. So I should not consider that as it is your level of learning or it is your behavior. Okay, your behavior, your reaction will be considered when you complete it. When you next day you condone yourself, then you realize that it was your mistake that you have not done an assignment. Then next day you bring the assignment, complete the assignment and bring it to me, and you submit it that assignment. That is a complete reaction. That is a total reaction of your behavior. Okay, that is the complete reaction of your situation. How you reacting at a particular point of time, by considering that can be said as it is because of your learning. Okay, then learning is transferable. Definitely learning is transferable, correct? Learning is transferable. Whoever having a knowledge, whoever having an experience, that will be transferable. Like I am transferring my knowledge to you people in this particular subject, right? You may transfer this knowledge to your friend or your juniors or your colleague, or in future, if you become a teacher, you will remember my teaching and you just say the same points, or as a, you know, it is like a chain, right? It is a transferable. It is not like I have learned something, it will be kept with me only, and I am going to leave this universe without teaching to anyone. Okay, learning can be transferred to one person, to one other person, to one organism, to another organism. It is not only restricted to people, okay, human being. Learning is a process, not a product, okay? So process means it is a continuous thing, right? We have learned about this thing in the previous slide. So learning is a continuous process which is acquiring skills and knowledge by everyday practice. Right? It is a process. It is not a product that you are going to a shop and buying it. No, it is not a product. So it is a process by, it is a continuity. Okay. So you are going to practice it every day, and it is a process. It is going to happen, you know, in all modes of your life. So that is learning is called as a process. Okay. Next one, the process of learning is determined by conscious as well as unconscious experience. Okay, so conscious as unconscious experience. Remember, in the beginning, I have given you example of a rain and pakoda and a cup of chai. So that is the example of unconscious experience. Like hope that rain and the smell of soil has modified your mind in a such a way that unconsciously you are not thinking that about consciously. You may be staying in a hostel these days, or you are not with your parents. Still, that smell, a smell of rain, will remind you of your home for a cup of chai and a pakoda, right? So that is the unconscious experience, right? It is not like with your consciousness only learning is taking place. Okay, if you're exposed to some kind of things every day, every time, which you are not, without your conscious, you are learning it. Okay, without your conscious, you are learning it. So that will reflected in after some days in your behavior. Okay, that will reflect in your behavior. So this is about the characteristics of learning. Okay, so these are the characteristics of learning. Next, we are going to discuss about the principles of learning. Okay, to learn something, you have to have the motivation. Okay, you want to play a good cricket, that's why you went to a cricket coaching. You want to achieve something in your life in business field or a management field, that is why we have joined this particular course, VVRM, right? So there should be some motivation. Without motivation, we cannot force anybody to learn something. Okay, so without motivation, learning will not take place. So always should be, we have to have an urge to learn. Okay, the person who is having the urge to learn, a person who want to learn, think, then only the learning takes place. Okay, how much ever you force to you to learn something, if you don't have interest or if you are not motivated to learn, if you don't have an urge to learn the particular thing, then you will not learn it. Okay, next one is reinforcement to develop or strengthen the desirable behavior. Here reinforcement means a strong or a strength, we can say, strong force to develop, okay, or strengthen the what we are strengthening or what we are developing here. We are developing a desirable behavior. Okay, I want everyone to be at first hour at college at 8 a.m. every day. That is a desirable behavior from a student of a college, right? So what we do, we reinforce that behavior. Right, we reinforce that behavior. Who are coming late, we will may give a negative reference like punishment. Who are behaving, coming every day without fail, every day they are turning up at 8 a.m. We might give them a best student award or a best attendance award, something like that. Reinforcement will give a strong, force we will apply to make you to behave what we are desiring. Okay, what is accepted a behavior from your side. So this is one principle of learning. Okay, so I was telling, learning always takes place in the complete. It is a complete chain. It is a not complete chain. Okay, so that is what it says about whole versus part learning. Okay, so say for example, you have started learning some skill outside the college. I'm talking like some sand art or some kind of drawing or something, right? So if you complete you complete the course of whatever the term it is having, then you become a good artist in that particular field. That is a whole learning. A part learning is also learning, but it will not fetch you the result what you learn in a whole. After learning a complete course, you might achieve the whatever the object you have, you may become a good artist. But you learn it in a part, then it will become a part of your hobby, or you cannot become a a successful person in that particular field. Okay, next one is meaningfulness of material. Okay, so material, I'm talking about material is nothing but information, knowledge, what we are saying in material. What we say in our classroom, do you have a study material? Those are your notes, books, right? Things which support your study, right? So whenever we are giving a coaching or a training, or we are practicing, we should provide with the right kind of material. Okay, for your cricket coaching, your coach experience is a right kind of material. His skills, what he's having, that is a material which we are talking about. Okay, so in a classroom to teach organizational behavior, the material would be the books which I ask you to refer, the notes I give you in the classroom, the notes I give you in some, I share you in a digital platform, okay, the videos I ask you to watch. So this will complement your learning. When you want to understand this organizational behavior subject, I have to provide you with the kind of material. Okay, for cricket coaching also, the skills, knowledge and the techniques of that cricket should be, I'm taking one sport example here, just like that, by thinking that everybody's favorite sport is cricket. Okay, so but to learn that cricket also, you have to have the material supplied to you. That is, the material will be skills, techniques of cricket, okay, experience of that coach, okay. The task will be a material. So when you give the meaningful material which complement your training or a coaching, okay, which you can practice every day. So that is what the principle of learning will say. Next one is feedback. So how feedback in the classroom learning? So I was giving here example of organizational behavior subject, how the feedback is collected by conducting tests and exams for the students. Okay, in a cricket coaching, say for example, by conducting some matches, tournaments, that how you're performing, taking test there also, right? So these are the principles of learning, five principles of learning, what we say. First one is motivation. Without motivation, learning will not take place. So we have to reinforce the behavior to take a driven, reinforce the behavior to get a desirable behavior from any person. Next one is whole versus the benefit of whole learning versus part learning. Next one is, so you, whatever the material we are providing for the training or for the practice, that should be a meaningful material, that it should complement. Teach OB, I cannot give you financial management material, but the learning, this is also management subject. You just not take a financial management, like let us take principle and practice of management. Those are the complementary subject. Okay, when you know the principle and practice management, then only you can understand the organizational behavior, vice versa. When you know the organizational behavior, principle and practice of management you will be knowing about. So if I give you the material about planning, organizing, directing and controlling, and I'll ask you to pass the examination of organizational behavior, where you have a learning group behavior, perception, personality and all, you cannot pass it, right? So that's why I'm saying that the material should, complement your learning. Correct. Next one is feedback. So whatever the learning stage, to test that whether learning has taken place or not, so we have to have the feedback process. Okay, so students, this is about the today's class. We have learned about what and all we have learned. We have learned about, in the learning model, we have learned about meaning, definition, characteristics and principles of learning. Okay, in coming classes I'll be continuing with the, in the same module, about the theories of learning. Okay, I hope you all understood this, and stay home, stay safe, students.